Welcome back. Today we are going to talk about the distributive property of binary operation, which is basically about sharing to distribute. All right, so let's look at the basic distributive property in arithmetic. For example, if we have a problem like 5, so this is 5 times 3 plus 2, right? 5 times a group of two quantities, 3 plus 2, that we have to simplify. You know, we can use the basic order of operation to simplify this, right? By multiplying the 5 by the group. So, you know, we're going to have 5 times 3 plus 2 is what? 5. Okay, then we'll go ahead and see that 5 times 5 is what? 25. Good. Another way that we can do this is to use the distributive property, where we'd have to distribute the quantity 5 to the two quantities in a bracket, right? And so we are going to see that, let me put a line over here. Good. We're going to have 5 times 3, so we have 5 times 3 plus 5 times what? 2. 5 times 2. So we have distributed the quantity 5 between the two quantities in the bracket, right? So 5 times 3 is what? 15. Then we have plus 5 times 2 is what? 10. So we can go ahead and see that 15 plus 10 is what? 25, which is actually the same as what we got over here. And the two quantities are equivalent. And so the distributive property is actually a way of rewriting the basic order of operation method that we know in a different form. Okay, yes. We can also have, let's say, 4 times 5 minus 2. All right, good. We can simplify this using the basic order of operation method we know, all right, by saying that we're going to multiply the 4 by the group of quantity we have over here. So we have 4 times 5 minus 2 is actually 3, right? Which if you simplify, you get 4 times 3, which is what? 12. Good. We can also use the distributive property by distributing the 4 to the two quantities in the bracket, right? Which is going to be 4 times 5. So we have 4 times 5. Minus 4 times what? 2. Good. And so if you simplify this, you only have 4 times 5, which is what? 20, minus 4 times 2, which is what? 8. Right? So if you subtract 8 from 12, sorry, if you subtract 8 from 20, you're going to get what? 12, which is equivalent to what we've got over here. Right? So if you use the basic order of operation method that we know, you get the same answer as using the distributive property. And that is why I said the distributive property is a way of rewriting the basic order of operation method that we know in a different form. All right. It doesn't matter if the quantities you have in the bracket are more than 2. You can have something like 3 times 2 plus 3 plus what? 4. Something like this. You can simplify this using the basic order of operation method that we know. Just as 3 times 2 plus 3 is 5 plus 4 is 9. Right? We have 3 times 9 is going to give us what? 27. We can also do this using the distributive property by distributing the quantity 3 to all the elements or the numbers we have in the bracket. So we're going to have 3 times what? 2 plus 3 times 3 plus 3 times what? 4. Right? Good. And so 3 times 3 is going to give us 6 plus 3 times 3 is 9, plus 3 times 4 is what, 12. And then we can simplify this further to get 6 plus 9 as 15, and then 15 plus 12 will give us what, 27, which is actually equivalent to what we got over here. Alright, good. Alright, so before we go to the binary operation, let me talk about this. We can apply the distributive property in solving complicated multiplications like 5 times 47. Alright, if you have to perform a multiplication in which the number looks big like this, sometimes it becomes a problem. But we can easily apply the distributive property over here and see that we can rewrite this as 5 times 50 minus 3. Actually, 50 minus 3 is the same as what, 47, right? Good. And then this would be a lot easier to do by applying the distributive property, right? Because this is equal to 5 times 50 minus, right, minus 5 times what, 3, 5 times 3, right? Good. This will be very easy to do even without using tables and calculators, right? Because 5 times 50 will give us what, 250, minus 5 times 3 will give us what, 15. You can do this multiplication without using a calculator. Then you can easily go ahead and subtract 15 from what, 250, which is going to give you what, 235. Right, good. The same problem we can let me put this one aside. We can simplify this. 5 times 47, we can rewrite this one also as 5 times 40 plus what, 7. So 40 plus 7 is actually the same as what, 47. All right, so it's either you do it 50 minus 3 or what, 40 plus 7. Good. So this will be equal to, using the distributive property, 5 times what, 40 plus 5 times what, 7. 5 times 7. Good. And then, you know, always we do the multiplication first. So 5 times 40, you can do this without using calculator. 5 times 40 will give us what, 200 plus 5 times 7 is what, 35. All right, so this is a lot easier than this one, because you can multiply 5 times 40 without calculator and then 5 times 7 without calculator. Good. So now you can go ahead and see that 200 plus 35 will give you 235, which is actually the same as what we got over here. You can also have an example like 3 times 125. Right, good. We can rewrite this one as 3 times, you know, 100 plus 2, this plus 20 plus what, 5. Good. 3 times 125 may be difficult for you to evaluate without using tables or calculator, but then if you're able to expand the 125 like we have over here, it should be a lot easier. And say that 3 times 100, using the distributive property, 3 times 100 plus 3 times 20 plus 3 times 5. Okay, so plus over here 3 times what, 5. And then we can perform this multiplications without using tables or calculator. This will be equal to 3 times 100 is what, 300, plus 3 times 20, we know this one will give us 60, plus 3 times 5 will give us what, 15. And you can easily add these three numbers, 300 plus 60 will give us 360, plus 15 will give us 375. So the distributive property is mostly helpful in performing operations or multiplications involving big values like this. Yes. All right, so let's go back to where we started. All right. Yes, and then talk about binary operations. These are basic binary operations that we've been using. So in the first example, we have 5 times 3 plus 2, right? Good. We have two operational signs, the multiplication and then what, the addition over here. All right. And we performed the operation using the basic order operation method, and we also used the distributive property method, and then we saw that the two sides or the two methods are giving us equivalent answers. In that case, we say that the operation multiplication is what, distributive over what, addition, right? Multiplication is distributive over what, addition. Good. In case over here too, we have two operational signs over here, the multiplication and what, subtraction. Right, and then we use the basic order of operation method. We had 12. We used the distributive property, and then what, we got 12. Since that is true, we can conclude that the operation multiplication is distributive over what, subtraction. The operation multiplication is distributive over what, subtraction. And so in general, we see that if you have two closed binary operations, let's say star and triangle, right, that have been defined over the set R of real numbers, such that A operation B operation C, the operation over here is star and is a triangle, right? So such that A star B triangle C is equal to A star B triangle A star C. Alright, for all A, B, and C belonging to the set R, we say that the operation star is distributive over what, the operation triangle, right? So if you have two binary operations that are closed, star and what, triangle, that has been defined over the set of real numbers R, such that A star B triangle C is equal to A star B, right, triangle A star C, right, for all the elements A, B, and C from the set of real numbers, we say that the operation star, right, the first operation is distributive over the second operation, right, the first operation is distributive over the second operation. Good. So let's quickly look at some simple examples. We have example one over here, which says that the operation star is defined by A star B is equal to 1/2 AB, and if A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 3 and C is equal to 4, we should evaluate A star B plus C, that is the I, and then II says that we should evaluate A star B plus A star C. Then also the third part says that, what conclusion can you draw about star, the operation star, from your answer in I and then II? All right. So let's quickly look at how we can answer this question. So we have over here solution. The operation has been defined as A star B is equal to 1/2 AB. Alright, now the first question says we should evaluate A star, or they have B plus C. Alright, but we were told that the value of A is equal to 2, the value of B is equal to 3, and the value of C is equal to 4. What it means is that wherever we find A, we're going to put what 2, and then wherever we find B, we're going to put what 3. And wherever we find C, we're going to put 4. Can we simplify? Good. So we have our A is what? 2 star. Our B is what? 3 plus our C is what? 4. All right. You know, we can simplify this using the basic order of operation that we know. So we have 2 star. 3 plus 4 gives us what? 7. Right, so now we have 2 star 7 to evaluate using the defined operation. Right, so in this case, as we know, our A is what 2 and our B is what 7. Right, good. And so wherever we find A in a definition, we are going to put 2, and wherever we find B, we are going to put what 7. So this is equal to 1/2 of 2 times what? 7. Right? Which will be equal to 1/2 of 2 times 7 is what? 14. And it's going to give us what? 7. 7, because 2 goes here 1 and 2 goes here what? 7 times. Alright. So we are done with the first part of the question. Right? We are done with this part of the question. Let's do the So we have the II over here, which says that we should evaluate A star B plus A star C. Alright, and then we're told that our A is 2, our B is 3, and our C is 4. So put the substituted values inside. Our A is 2. Star our B is what? 3 plus our A is 2, star our C is what? 4. Good. So now we have 2 star 3 and then 2 star 4 to evaluate using the defined operation, right? That is a basic addition, and so we don't have to worry much about that. You only have to apply the defined operation to evaluate the groups we have in the bracket. So in this case, right, in this case, our A is what? 2 and our B is what? 3. When you come here, your A is what? 2 and our B is what? 4. So in simplifying this side, wherever we find A in a definition, you're going to put 2, and wherever we find B, you're going to put 3. When you come here, our A is 2. Alright, so wherever we find A in a definition, we put 2, and our B is 4. So wherever we find B in a definition, we're going to put what? 4. Good. So we have 1/2 2 times 3 plus over here 1/2 2 times what? 4. Right? So we have substituted the value of A and B into the definition. Other side, and then you substitute the value of A and B into the definition on the side here. Go ahead and then what? Simplify. So this will be equal to 1/2 2 times 3 is 6 plus 1/2 2 times 4 is 8. Alright, and this will be equal to 1/2 of 6 is 3 plus 1/2 of 8 is what? 4. Which in turn gives us what? 7, right? 7. So you're getting 7 over there too. Good. Now let's look at the third question. The third question says that what conclusion can you draw about the operation from your answer in your answers, right? From your answers in I and II. So in I, we got the answer what? 7, right? We got the answer 7. And then In II2, our answer is what, 7. What does it tell you? You know, what it means is that A star B plus C, right, is equal to A star B plus A star C, right? Because A star B plus C is given as 7, and then A star B plus A star C is also given as 7. So it means A star B plus C is equal to A star B plus A star C, which we can write as A star B plus C is equal to this one, A star B plus A star what, C, right? So it's the distributive property, right? So you distribute the quantity A to the two groups or two quantities in a bracket, B and C, right? So we have A star B over here plus over here A star C also over there, right? So since A star B plus C is equal to A star B plus A star C, it implies the operation star is distributive over the operation what, addition, right? It implies the operation star you have over here is distributive over the operation what, addition. All right, let's look at another simple example over here. This one says that the operation star is defined under set P, which contains the element 4, 6, 8, and 10, by A star B is equal to 1/2 A minus B. So if A is equal to 8, B is 6, and C is 4, evaluate I, A star B plus C, and II, A star B plus A star C. And the B part says that, what conclusion can you draw about the operation star from your answers in AI and what, II? Good, let's quickly begin the solution over here. So the solution, all right, the operation has been defined as by A star B is equal to 1/2 A minus B. You have to write that down so that you don't waste your time or worry yourself referring to it in a question which you may not see. All right, so the A part says that, in fact, I says we should evaluate A star to bracket B plus C, right, where the A is 8, the B is 6, and the C is what, 4. What it means is that, as in the first example, where we find A, we put 8, where we find B, we put 6, and then where we find C, we're going to put what, 4. So let's do that quickly and see what we are going to get. So we have 8 star, a B is 6, plus our C is what, 4. All right, so we actually simplify this using the basic order of operation that we know. So we have 8 star 6 plus 4 is giving us what, 10, right? So simplify this first bracket. Now we have 8 star 10, right? We can see our A is 8 and our B is what, 10. So in the definition, wherever we find A, we put 8, and where we find B, we put what, 10. So this is going to be equal to 1/2 A, our A is 8, so 8 minus our B is what, 10, right? So this will be equal to 1/2, 8 minus 10 is giving us negative 2, then this will be equal to 1/2 of negative 2 is what, negative 1, right? Negative 1. So we are getting negative 1 and I. So we have the II over here. II. We have to evaluate A star B plus A star C, for which we were told A is 8, B is 6, plus A is 8, our C is what, 4. Good. So now we have another problem to simplify using the defined equation. And first group, our A is 8 and our B is what, 6, plus the second group, our A is 8 and our B is what, 4. So whenever we find A in a definition in the first group over here, we're going to put 8 and then B, 6. When we come to the second group, our A is 8 and then that is it. So we have 1/2 8 minus our B is what, 6, plus 1/2 our A is 8 minus our B is what, 4, right? And so this one would have 1/2 of 8 minus 6 is giving us what, 2, plus 1/2 of 8 minus 4 will give us what, 4, which will be equal to 1/2 of 2 is 1, plus 1/2 of 4 is what, 2, which would give us what, 3. So you're getting 3 in this case. Good. Now the B part says that, the B part says that from the answers we are getting in the I, this answer, and then the II, what conclusion can we draw? Right now, so you see that in AI, A star B plus C, we are getting negative 1. And then the II, A star B plus A star C, we are getting what, 3, which are not the same. So we can say that since A star B plus C is not equal to, right, A star B plus A star C, right, they are not equal, because the answer for A star B plus C is negative 1 and the answer for A star B plus A star C is what, 3. Therefore they are not the same. So since they are not the same, it implies the operation A star B plus C is not equal to A star B plus A star C, the operation star is not distributive over the operation what, addition. All right, and so in this example, we're given two operations, star and then triangle, when defined over the set of real numbers by A star B is equal to A minus 2B, and A triangle B is equal to A plus B minus AB, right? And so we are asked to calculate the value of 4 star 5 triangle 3, and then calculate the value of 4 star 5 triangle 4 star 3. And then from the answers we get over here, we are asked to draw a conclusion. Good. So now we have two different operations, A star B and then A triangle B. Alright, so let's look at how we answer these questions. The first one, A. I always advise you to write the definition star. So A star B is equal to A minus 2B. And then A triangle B is equal to A plus B minus AB. In this example, in the first, or in the I, we have 4 star 5 triangle 3 to simplify. Good. You see that you have the operation star and then you have the operation what, triangle. The operation star has been defined by A minus 2B. And then the operation triangle has been defined by a plus b minus what ab. And then you have to solve. But what we know in mathematics is that we solve the bracket first. Right? And so the operation for the bracket is what? Triangle. And therefore we're going to use the definition over here. Right? Good. So now we have 4 star 5 triangle what? 3. In this case our a is what? 5 and our b is what? 3. So wherever we find a in this definition, we are going to put what? 5. And then b we are going to put what? 3. So let's go ahead and do that. We have 5 plus 3 minus 5 times what? 3. Right? We are using this definition because the operation over here is what? Triangle. Good. So now we have 4 star 5 plus 3 is giving us 8 minus 5 times 3 is giving us what? 15. Go ahead and simplify this. You get 4 operation 8 minus 15 will give us negative 7. Right? Good. So now we have 4 star negative 7 to simplify. This time the operation over here is star, and therefore we are going to use the definition over here. Right, let me continue this over here. So 4 star negative 7 will be equal to our a over here is what? 4. And then our a is 4 and our b is what? Negative 7. So in a definition, in place of a, you're going to put 4. In place of b, you put what? Negative 7. So you have 4 minus 2 times b is what? Negative 7. This will be equal to 4 plus, right? Negative 2 times negative 7 gives us positive 14. And so we have 18. The II says we should simplify 4 star 5 triangle 4 star 3. Good. You have two operations, the star and what? The triangle. So in this first group, because the operation is star, we are going to use the definition over here, right? And in second group two, the operation is what? Star. Therefore, we're going to use the definition what? Over here. All right, so let's quickly do that. In the first group, our a is 4, our b is what? 5. So we have 4 minus 2 times 5. Right, for our first group triangle. Our second group, our a is 4, our b is what? 3. So we have 4 minus 2 times the b is what? 3. Are we there? Yes. And so we go ahead and simplify this. You have 4 minus 2 times 5 is 10 triangle. When you come here to, you have 4 minus 2 times 3 is 6. Okay, good. So 4 minus 10 will give us negative 6 triangle. 4 minus 6 will give us negative what? 2. So we go ahead and then evaluate this. This time we have negative 6 triangle, negative 2. So this time the operation is what? Triangle. So we are going to make use of this definition, right? Now a is what? Negative 6. Our b is what? Negative 2. So let me do this over here. So we'd have negative 6 triangle negative 2 is equal to a is negative 6. So negative 6 plus our b is negative 2 minus negative 6 times negative 2. Is that right? Yes. Good. So this is equal to negative 6 plus negative 2 is equal to negative 8 minus, in the bracket you have negative 6 times negative 2, which will give us what? Positive 12. Right? Good. And this becomes equal to negative 8 minus 12, for which we are going to get negative 20. All right, negative 20. All right, so that's the answer for the II. Okay, good. Now let's look at the B part. The B part says that from the answers we got in AI, this one, and in II, this one, what conclusion can we draw? You realize that this is very easy to do. All right, good. So you pause the video and then write your conclusion down. All right, so let's see. In 4*5 × 3, we got 18. And over here, 4*5 × 4*3, we are getting what? Negative 20, right? So if you want to write, you see that 4*5 × 3 is not equal to this one. 4*5 × 4*3, right? Because the answers are not the same. In this case, we got 18. In that case, we got negative 20, right? So since 4*5 × 3 is not equal to 4*5 × 4*3, it implies the operation is not distributive over the operation what? Triangle. Right. Assuming we had 18 over here and then we got 18 over here as well, then we can conclude that since 4*5 × 3 is equal to whatever we have over here, it implies the operation star is distributive over the operation triangle. But in this case, it's not distributive over the operation triangle because the answer we go over here is different from the answer we had over here. So what we are saying about the distributive property is that we have two closed binary operations, star and then triangle, defined by the set of real numbers, such that A star B triangle C is equal to A star B triangle A star C, right? For all A, B and C belonging to the set of real numbers, right? Or if A can be distributed between B and C, right, and we're going to get the same values, then we see that the operation star, okay, the operation we have over here, is distributive over the operation triangle, the operation we have over here. Anyway, so we see the first operation is distributive over the second operation. Thanks for watching.